Hello, and welcome to the series on the multiphysics analysis of a car headlamp in Simcenter 3D. In this series of videos, we will demonstrate how Simcenter 3D provides advanced functionalities in geometry preparation, meshing, solution setup, and post-processing that allow the user to manage a multiphysics digital twin in a robust and efficient way. In the first video of this series, we will show an example of how CAD parts in an assembly can be simplified and prepared for meshing. Okay, so now we have our part assembly open, and you can see the different parts on the left. And if we want to make some modifications, let's say to this part, we can open it in a new window and isolate it from the rest of the assembly, and easily do that. So here we're going to delete these raised faces, and we're going to use a replace face command for that. So basically you just select these raised faces, select the replacement face, hit OK, and that's it. And underneath you can see there were some slots, so if we wanted to remove those, we can use the delete face command and use the slot face feature and delete those as well. Okay, and one more example is how to delete faces using a pocket or boss sensing option. So we have this complicated geometry here. If we put that option on and delete face, you can see the result. So we just fill everything and simplify it. Here we can also use the replace face on these ribs. That's also quite easy, and that's it. So you can see it's quite easy to work with here, and any changes we made here are automatically updated in our part assembly. So let's go there. And here we have it. You can see on the right, we have our part updated now and ready to take to the next step. In this video, we saw how to do a simple geometry modification on a part in our assembly to prepare it for meshing. When further changes are required on this part after the complete model has been built, any of the CAD changes can be rolled forward and updated in meshing and boundary condition application without significant rework. In the next video, we will demonstrate the capability to define an assembly fem from the assembly structure of the CAD geometry and apply a mesh to the components.